Hi everyone, welcome to Crime and Search. Today we will talk about the case that is trending in the true crime community, the murder of Kai Tian Fong, Abby Choi, which happened not long ago. Believe everyone has heard about the incident more or less. A wealthy lady was brutally murdered, left with an incomplete body, and even some body parts were cooked. It was hard to believe when you learn about this information in 2023. This happened in Hong Kong in February 2023, and the killer was not a lone wolf-type serial killer, but rather an entire family. They are the ex-husband, the ex-father-in-law who was a bad ex-cop, and the driver of the victim who is also the ex-husband's brother. The whole incident can be summarized as the real-life story of Parasite. In the end, what happened? Let us dive into the existing information disclosed for now. The victim Kai Tian Fong, Abby Choi, was born in Hong Kong in 1994. It can be said that she is the oldest princess of a rich family. Born and raised in a wealthy business family, her parents are both businessmen in China mainland with assets estimated to reach hundreds of millions. She also has two younger sisters. In 2012, Abby Choi stepped foot into the fashion circle as a model, with frequent participation in fashion events, meeting many fashion people and artists. Out of these people, she had a very good personal relationship with Aaron Kwok's wife, Mocha Fong. They often frequently visit each other. Even their social media showed many pictures of the two together. With a wealthy family, good networks, and also a good career in the fashion industry, she is an undeniable socialite. She was debuted in the major shows of Paris Fashion Week not long ago. 8 days before the murder, she also appeared on the cover of fashion magazines. Not only her family is rich, but her current husband's family is also wealthy in Hong Kong. Abby Choi and Chris Tam got married in 2016. He is the son of Tam Chuk Kwan, the founder of Hong Kong famous Yunnan rice noodle restaurant Tam Jai Yunnan Mixian. Abby gave birth to two children. Maybe it's because it was too difficult to deal with both sides' finance. The two just had a wedding and did not officially register for marriage. The one that murdered Abby was her ex-husband's family. Before Chris, Abby had a previous marriage. She knew the guy, Alex Kwong Kong Chi, since they were 15 years old in high school. The two married soon after they turned 18 and gave birth to a boy and a girl. During this marriage, the living expenses of the ex-husband's family were all arranged by Abby. Instigated by her ex-husband, she took out a few million Hong Kong dollars to invest in an egg waffle shop business for Alex. Although the store soon went bankrupt and closed down, she never blamed Alex. Instead, she covered for him from the criticism of their friends and family. Besides that, Abby also contributed money to her ex-husband's brother Anthony to start several companies. She helped Alex's relatives inside and out, but good times don't last long. Because of personality incompatibility, their married life ended after only 3 years and Alex got custody of the children. Even though Abby remarried in 2016 and started a new life, her ex-husband's family stuck to her like a big parasite. According to the recent record, her ex-husband has been staying in Hong Kong with no serious job and not doing anything. Their daily living expenses were mainly supported by Abby. In 2014, Alex committed a fraud crime involving a sum of money up to 5 million Hong Kong dollars. Although arrested by the police, he later absconded and became a wanted man. Her ex-husband's elder brother Anthony Kwong Kong Kit became Abby's personal driver after destroying the companies Abby funded. He drove luxury cars every day and accompanied Abby to various parties. Although having a lot of debt, Anthony still posted a bunch of luxury cars and watches on his social media and went to restaurants that ordinary people can't afford. In 2019, Abby bought a luxury condo in Kadori Hill, and because of tax issues, she registered the house in her ex-husband's father's name. She then let her ex-husband's family move in and live in it. This condo became the fuse of this murder case. This year in 2023, Abby wanted to sell this house at a low price, but she was met with fierce opposition from her ex-husband's family. She promised again and again that she will arrange for the family to live in another place, just in a slightly cheaper house, and will provide for their living expenses. But the ex-father-in-law still told her that if you dare to sell the house, I will kill you. This scum ex-father-in-law, Kwong Kao, is not a good person. He used to be a professional detective sergeant in the police force and had been a policeman for many years. He even received a commendation from his leaders. But that was all on the surface. In 2005, he was involved in obtaining contact information for a rape victim by abusing his power, contacting her, and allegedly raping her. After this incident, he had to take the blame and resign. That's why he didn't stand in the criminal court. Although the registered Title F residence of this condo was all under the name of the former father-in-law Kwon Kao, but as the actual investor, Abby only needs to submit the evidence of her contribution to the court, then she can get back the property rights and she can dispose of the property at her own will. Kwon Kao's family didn't have any serious job with reliable income and no real estate. If they get into trouble with Abby again and the house gets taken away, then they have nowhere to go. But without Abby, then that house would truly be theirs. The Kwong family gradually developed murderous intentions. In addition, Abby did not register her marriage with her current husband Chris. Therefore, in the absence of a legal will, if Abby dies, then in theory, the children of her and her ex-husband would have at least the right to inherit half of her estate. Since the Kwong family had custody, that is equivalent to them taking the house. Maybe that's why the Kwong family finally make up their minds to kill Abby without anyone noticing. On February 21, 2023, Abby left her residence on Kadori Hill, took a trip to a school in Hong Kong Science Park to pick up her eldest daughter from school. The driver of the vehicle is none other than the ex-husband's brother Anthony. According to the police report, when the vehicle drove to the entrance of the Lion Rock Tunnel, the ex-husband Alex got in the car. It should be at this time, they knocked out Abby and killed her. Surveillance monitoring displayed this car met up with the 7-seater car driven by Kwon Kao, the ex-father-in-law. They drove to a house in Long Mae Suen. This village house is beside both mountains and sea, and it's next to a large landfill with 5,000 tons of garbage burned daily. Kwon Kao, who has been a policeman, chose this place to throw a dead body. They can throw body parts in the water, bury parts in the mountains, and even directly mix the parts with garbage in this landfill. This was an excellent location. They rented out the place 2 weeks before the incident. So it's indeed a planned murder. After transporting Abby into this village house, the three worked together to decompose and cook her and later transported body parts in vehicles. According to nearby villagers, they heard some sounds from the house in the early morning. There was an intermittent banging sound and there was also the sound of women and men arguing. They thought it was a couple fighting. So no one called the police. After the early morning of the 21st, Abby did not come to school to pick up the child and never came home. The current husband Chris was very worried about her. He thought something happened to her. Chris contacted the driver Anthony, but Anthony lied that Abby got out of the car midway to the school and never told him where she went. Chris knew something was wrong and called the police immediately. The case was passed to Kowloon West Regional Headquarters. Major Crime Squad was quickly dispatched. On February 24th, the police believe that the Kwong family are suspicious and arrested three people. A total of two men and one woman, including the ex-husband's father Kwong Kao, the ex-husband's brother Anthony, and the ex-husband's mother Jenny Lee Sui-hyung. The ex-husband Alex had already escaped and gone missing. Abby's relatives and friends put a reward of 2 million Hong Kong dollars on Alex's whereabouts. The police first demanded the dashcam from Anthony and he claimed the footage had been damaged. The police conveniently learned Abby's last locations from surveillance cameras and the whereabouts of the Kwong family on that day. They finally locked onto that village house 11 kilometers away from the pickup location. The police found Abby's body parts, which have not yet been processed, inside the house. Her body had been dismembered into several pieces. Only two leg parts were found in the freezer. There was also a pot of unknown liquid suspected to be mixed with human tissue. This village house was very empty. There was only a bed sheet and didn't even have basic furniture like a bed. The police suspect that this house was rented for the sole purpose of disposing of the dead body. After searching, they found a meat slicer, chainsaw, raincoat, gloves, masks, and other tools used to dispose of the body. Inside the village house, the police also found Abby's Hermes bag and it had a relevant identification inside, but the rest of the body parts had yet to be found, especially her head, which can prove her identity, and her hands with fingerprints. Police initially suspected that her head was discarded in the nearby Tseong Kwan O, so they launched divers, a police search team, an aerial search team, and police dogs up to more than 100 personnel, including drones. They searched within a diameter of 200 meters, which covered the nearby cistern landfills, hillsides, etc. Afternoon on the 25th, report via informant the police arrested Alex, who was going to take a speedboat to escape. He had more than 500,000 Hong Kong dollars in cash on him, along with several famous watches with a total value of more than 4 million Hong Kong dollars. On the afternoon of February 26, 2023, the police found a large soup pot about half a meter high, and there they dug out Abby's head was found. The tissues on the skull were still intact. Behind the right ear, they found a 6.5 centimeters long, 5.5 centimeters wide knife wound. It should be the main cause of death for Abby. There was not only the skull and sternum in the soup pot, there were even carrots. Although flesh and bone had been separated, the skull was not deformed, so try to add carrots to make the soup look like kitchen waste. If the police do not find the crime scene in time and the body was successfully thrown by the Kwong family in the landfill disposal, no one would ever find it ever again. Other than the Kwong family, the police arrested the mistress of Kwong Kao on the streets of Tsim Sha Tsui, Ing Chi Wing. She worked at a massage parlor. She assisted Kwong Kao in renting the village house used for disposing of the body. Since she is a masseuse, she knows the joints and tissues of the human body. The police speculate she was the one who assisted in the dismemberment of Abby. After the murder of Abby, all of her relatives and friends came to mourn her. Aaron Kwok and his wife Mocha Fon also expressed their condolences in person. Her friends said she was a very simple and kind girl. She also often participates in charity and founded an animal welfare organization. She cared for her family and friends. Her kindness and tenderness should have brought her a happy life, but in the end, it was exploited by the diabolical and greedy Kwong family. At present, the Hong Kong police have officially charged the Kwong family with murder, damaging bodies, and obstructing police duties. We will receive more sad and shocking truths in the next stage of the investigation and trial. We will continue to pay attention to this case. Thank you for watching. Stay safe and stay alert.